Hi, this video is pretty different from usual. I just wanted to show Quicktexture, that is an add-on to create procedural textures in Blender, that works with Eevee and Cycles, how to take those textures into Octane without too much trouble. So this is the Quicktexture add-on. I will show you some basic characteristics of it. Then the add-on I use to bake is SimpleBake. It's an add-on for Blender that makes it very easy to bake procedural textures into images. And then I will use this other add-on, APOctane, with a lot of useful settings and tools to use Octane in Blender. I also suggest this free add-on, Node Wrangler Octane. It's substitute for the usual Node Wrangler, and it changes it with a version that works also with the Octane nodes. If you use Octane in Blender, I suggest also this other add-on, the helper add-on. I will not use it in the video, but I suggest to use this. So here we have a scene that is without textures. We have an object that has UVs. You can see here this object is just a subdivided plane, so it has the original UVs of the plane. This instead has no UVs because I made it from boxes and then I deleted the UV map because it was all wrong. To use Quicktexture, you just have to select the object and press Ctrl T, and you can choose some maps. I choose three maps: diffuse, glossiness, normal. I create the material, view it in the material preview. The nice thing about Quicktexture is that you can change. So you can press V and increase the value, C, saturation, H for the U. You can scale the texture, rotate. In the N panel, Quick Tools, Quicktexture, you have all the keys. You can also add other layers, Ctrl B, and I can choose other textures. For example, now I choose just diffuse and normal. In this new layer, I can do all the usual things. I can also go and change the roughness, even interactively. And now I can mask, for example, by height. So I can also invert the mask, increase the contrast. I can add the noise. And now I mixed these two textures in one. I can still change everything, even interactively. When I'm okay, I press Ctrl T and I have all this texturing easily done. I will do the same thing for this object that has no UVs. It's the same. Ctrl T, just select the maps, and the material will be box projected on my object. Adjust the scale and also non-uniformly. And add another layer, the same sand as before. I don't use the normal now. The same texture can become very different. Ctrl H for a mask. And I have this other material created very easily. Now, if I want to go to Octane, I can use APOctane, and so I click Octane Render Engine. I'm using Blender for Octane, and now I'm in Octane. I can just add the environment, and also there is the setup color management. There are a lot of options in this add-on. I just wanna to rotate the sun. Obviously, we don't have the materials because the materials in Eevee are not compatible with Octane. I need to replace all this with Octane nodes. But you can see that this shader is huge. We have to switch back to Eevee, Z, and go to Eevee. And now we can bake the textures. We will use SimpleBake. You have to select the object. Don't use advanced object selection, just select the object. You can choose what channels. Usually I bake diffuse, roughness, and normal. This is the resolution. You can start with a test resolution. It's very low, just for a test. Here you have the option to create new UV maps for your object, but for this terrain there are already the UV maps, so I don't check this. And here you can give a name to your textures. And this is a nice option, copy objects and apply bakes. You will get a new copy of this object with the new texture. This doesn't change the original object. And you can hide or not the original object just after bake. Here, choose the device. If you don't see it in the preferences, just control to have selected CUDA or optics for your card. If you check optics, you will get a warning. Users have reported problems baking with GPU and optics. I leave CUDA, but just try with the optics. It's easy as pressing bake, but as you can see, there is an error because the material made by Quicktexture is hidden inside this shader group. And that's the problem. We just have to ungroup this. So Ctrl-Alt-G and you can ungroup. After ungrouping, you can't get the group back. So if you plan to use Quicktexture again, maybe it's better to create a duplicate of this material and ungroup the duplicate. So you can always go back. This is 001 with the three ungrouped. And the original is here if you have to go back to edit it with Quicktexture. So I work on this copy. I try with a test resolution, bake. I wait. And now I have a new plane. I didn't hide this. And this is the new plane. There is still this modifier that needs to be removed. Otherwise, you can see the textures in the wrong place. This is just to check if it works. It works. So I delete this object. I go back to my original plane and I can bake at 2K, bake. Now I have the baked plane. We can check the textures. Here you can see how they are. What's the problem? The problem, if your object has UVs, you don't want to make new UVs, but make sure to select the proper UV map. You just have to select it because Quicktexture creates a new UV map. You have to select the original one. Otherwise, the bake will use the other. So I select this and I bake. I have the new plane. I can hide this collection and go here. You can see from this tree is the object with the baked texture. And here we have the texture. Now we can easily switch back Z to Octane. And with the APOctane, we have this button, convert to Octane matte. And now the material is an Octane material and it works perfectly. The textures are being plugged to the correct inputs. So let's see with the other object. I go back to Eevee. I hide the objects baked and I unhide the UV ones. This is the fangs. The fangs has no UVs, so I just press new UV maps. It will perform a smart UV project on the object and it will create the UVs for this object. I can call it fangs. And now I press bake, the usual problem with the material, duplicate and ungroup, bake. And now I have the new objects. I can hide the old ones. This is still an Eevee material, Z, Octane, convert to Octane, and it's okay. We just have the smoothing option, one check. And so it's pretty easy with this addon to convert all the texture. Obviously, if you want to change something, you have to go back to the original materials, to EV, hide this, recover the old object, select, the original material without the ungrouping. And now with Ctrl T, you can restart Quicktexture, for example, adding a new layer. I select this red texture. So now my material is different. Now I have to bake again, duplicating the material, Ctrl Alt G to ungroup it. I received an error, but there's no problem. Bake it, go back to Octane. I hide the EV object. It's still an EV material, so select Convert to Octane. As usual, smooth. The new bake will replace the original texture, so the old object doesn't work anymore. If you want to keep the other, you just have to change the name in the bake options. Here, change this name, otherwise it will replace the original. This is a bake with the 2K, there is less detail than in the original. So this is my solution for the time being to have Quicktexture result baked in order to use it with Octane or any other render engine that is not Cycles or Eevee. I really like Quicktexture, is great to work fast with textures, mix. Sometimes you just want something fast and not something precise. It would be difficult to develop a version that works with Octane. The bake is a solution, not so real time, but can solve some problems. It's not too difficult. So just to wrap up how to do, you can have a collection with the objects in Eevee and the objects in Octane that are the baked ones. When you have a new object, shade smooth, Ctrl T, select maps. Make what you want with your material, rotate, whatever you want with the Quicktextures, metalness. I can change the roughness, move the map of the roughness. Let's say that I'm happy with this material. Go here to SimpleBake, everything selected as before. Find a new name. I ungrouped the nodes A, dot to get everything, Ctrl Alt G to ungroup. And bake. Hide the old objects, metallic again. I switch to Octane, convert to Octane matte, and here I have the Octane material. Mistakenly, I choose to create the new UV maps. This addon made a new UV map for my sphere. I just have to delete the object, go back to the original object, and as I said, you have to select the original UV map, simple bake. Deselect new UV maps and click bake again, and now this has the original UV map. Just check not to have any modifier that changes the position of the texture. If it's all okay in EV, go back to Octane, convert to Octane matte. You can hide the EV objects, and metallic wasn't checked. Now this is an Octane material. As I said, the colors are not the same. I can fix a bit the gamma. It's just the Octane viewport. It has a world with more light, and so the colors are slightly different. Could be useful for Octane, for every render engine different from Cycles and Eevee, and makes even more useful the Quicktexture addon. It's a very nice addon to create fast shading for your objects, and it's nice to have a way to bake. I think that one day in the new versions they will have a bake button inside the Quicktextures, but for the moment you can use simple bake to get the images from your procedural textures. I hope that this video could have been useful for you. Thanks and goodbye.